नमस्कार फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू लेसन 18 इन अवर कोर्स ऑन प्रोसेसिंग ऑफ पॉलीमर्स एंड पॉलीमर कॉम्पोजिट्स। वी हैव स्टार्टेड अवर डिस्कशन ऑन द वेरियस प्रोसेसिंग टेक्निक्स दैट आर यूज्ड फॉर प्रोसेसिंग ऑफ पॉलीमर कॉम्पोजिट्स। इफ यू रिमेंबर इन द लास्ट सेशन वी हैव सीन अ प्रोसेस विच इज कॉल्ड हैंड लेयर प्रोसेस, विच इज अ कंप्लीटली मैनुअल प्रोसेस इन विच द continuous reinforcement in the form of mat is used as a reinforcement in a plastic matrix. So the plastic that is used in case of hand layer process is majorly thermoset, and the examples we have taken were of epoxy and polyester. If you remember, we have seen a video also which is freely available on YouTube, and we have seen that how layer by layer the layers of composite are laid up, that is stacked up, and we make a laminate. So it is made in a layer by layer by layer by layer form. So the only difference that I foresee in a hand layer process and a spray layer process is that in spray layer we will have our reinforcement in the form of chopped fiber. Chopped means cut fiber, means small fibers. So in this case, in spray layer, our fibers will mostly be in the form of cut fibers or short fibers, whereas in case of hand layer process we have used continuous fiber reinforcement in which the fibers were there in both the directions, that is the warp and the weft. So if you remember, I have given the example of a cloth mat form. So as the shirt I am wearing, it also has fibers in both the directions. So similarly, we can have the glass fibers or carbon fibers or aramid fibers from the synthetic fibers family. We can have sisal fibers, we can have nitrile fibers, we can have jute fibers from the natural fibers family. So depending upon the family from where we have derived the fibers, we can have continuous fibers. Whereas in this case, we will try to understand it with the help of a video also, which is again freely available on YouTube. We will try to understand that how a spray layer process is done, but the major difference will be the fibers in this case will mostly be short fibers, and the polymer, how we combine the polymer and the fibers together is different in case of spray layer as compared to the hand layer process. So that is the major difference, and we have seen that hand layer process is limited in terms of complexity of the product that we can produce. So that is one limitation of hand layer, whereas in spray layer that complexity slightly reduces, or we can say that the spray layer process can be used for more complex shapes as compared to a hand layer process. So that is the another advantage of a spray layer process. So we will try to understand the differences between the hand layup and the spray layup process, and we will try to understand the intricacies involved in the spray layup process. So let us start our discussion with spray layup process. So this diagram, I think this figure will be shown in almost all presentations that we are going to cover, and this shows that this process falls under which category? Open mold category. So it is not a closed mold process, it is an open mold process. As you remember, in case of hand layer process we have seen the two metallic plates of mold in the example we have seen were there, and in between we have done the layup. Layer by layer by layer we have added maybe four layers and applied the polymer, because it was a thermoset, so it was available in the gel or the viscous form, and then we have put the top plate on top of the bottom plate. In between the laminate was there, and then we applied the nut and bolt fasteners and applied the pressure, and finally our composite was ready. So that was because that was continuous fiber and the mold was open to the environment, and we have also seen the curing may take place for 24 hours. Suppose today we have done the lamination and we have placed the laminate in between the two halves of the mold, we will get our cured, solidified, rigid composite the next day after 24 hours. Although we can accelerate the rate of curing by putting it in a oven or a autoclave, but that is also possible, but normally it may take 24 hours for the curing process to happen under ambient or the normal conditions of temperature and pressure. So that is one important thing. So here also we will see that the mold will be open. So it will not be a closed mold process. There also the mold was open. It was not closed from all sides. It was closed only from bottom and top. From sides it was open. Similarly in spray layup also we will see that the mold will be open. And we will spray our material, the constituents onto the shape, and finally the product will be ready. So again the spray layup process is also a open mold process. Again the first sentence, just to emphasize the point again and again, that it is an open mold process, an extension of the hand layup method. In the very beginning today I have tried to explain what is the difference between a hand layup and a spray layup method. Basic phenomenon in both the cases is same, that is we have to combine the two constituents of the composite material together, and the two constituents being the matrix and the reinforcement. So here also, but the method of combining the two will be different. In case of hand layup process it is different, in case of spray layup process it is different. We have already understood that in case of hand layup process how we are going to combine the reinforcement and the matrix together, and today we will try to see that how the reinforcement and the matrix will be combined together in case of a spray layup process. Now processing is similar to hand layup process. The only difference lies in the application of resin and fiber to the mold. Now if you remember, in hand layup process we have taken a bottom plate mold, then we have sprayed the release gel, then we have put a thin plastic film on the surface, then we have put the first layer of the fiber that was in the woven form or the mat form, then we have poured the viscous matrix or the polymer or the plastic on top of our layer of fibers, then we have applied pressure, or maybe we have applied it over the fibrous reinforcement or the fiber layer, then we have put the another layer of fiber, again we have applied the resin on that layer, again another layer, and again we have applied the resin, maybe 4 layers or 6 layers or 8 layers or 10 layers, whatever layers we want to lay up, we have laid those layers up, in between we have applied the resin. And finally, we have put another thin plastic film on top of that, and finally the upper part of the mold. And finally, we have fastened it using the nut and bolt arrangement. That was a simple process of hand layup, of combining the fiber and the polymer together. But here, how we will combine the fiber and the polymer together will be different, and that we will try to understand with the help of a diagram. The process is well suitable for small to medium volume production. So in case of hand layup it is mostly suitable for low volume production, but here low volume means that the number of products made per day, the number of products made per week is less in case of hand layup process, whereas in case of spray layup process that is medium to high or small to medium. The process is cost effective for producing small and large parts. So large parts can also be made, and today we will see the manufacturing of a boat using the spray layup process. On your screen you can see now a very simple diagram of a spray layup process. You can see here the mold remains the same. This is the mold. Then there is a release gel. It is shown with a different color. If you focus on the arrow, you will see a release gel is sprayed on the inner half of the mold. Then there is a polymer resin. Then there is a reinforcement. Both are coming together. And this is a roller for consolidation. There is a catalyst coming from here. There is a resin coming. This yellow color is a resin tube through which our matrix or the polymer is coming. The catalyst, as I have told in the previous class also, in case of thermosets we have to use a hardening agent or a hardener. So the hardener is coming from here, that is the catalyst. It acts as a catalyst. This is the resin or the polymer supply. This is the fiber roving, and through this we are getting the fibers. So basically three things are going as a constituent here. One is a polymer, another is a catalyst or the hardener, another is the fiber. So three things going together in the chopper gun, and as the name suggests, chopper. Chopper means it will cut the fibers into small pieces, and this type of process will be used for short fiber reinforced polymer composites. So chopping gun will chop the fibers, the polymer will and the fibers will combine together, and the mixture will be sprayed on the mold. So here, just to explain, we have shown the two parts, the resin and the polymer, separately, but in actual practice there will be a combination which will be sprayed on the inner part of the mold. So this is a schematic of the spray layer process. Now we can see in one go we will be achieving a particular thickness of the product. If we want to have more thicker or thicker product, we have to adjust the operating parameters, the flow of the resin, the flow of the fiber, the amount of catalyst entering into the chopper gun. So all these parameters we need to combine. Moreover, in some exceptional circumstances, we may even like to go for two passes, that in single pass we may deposit our material and then in the second pass we can again deposit the material, so that we get a thicker product. But the only limitation and the problem in this case will be that how the two layers will bond together and what would be the bond strength of the two layers deposited by two different passes. So that is another challenge that has to be overcome in order to make a good quality product using the spray layer process. So here we can see that this is similar, the mold is also similar. The only thing is how we are combining the fiber and the polymer together, and in this case it is combined together in the chopper gun. Now whatever I have tried to explain with the help of a diagram, let us try to understand it with the help of logical sentences. Spray release gel is applied on the mold surface, similar to hand layer process, only to facilitate the easy removal of the component from the mold. If we do not spray the release gel, there is a tendency that the composite product which has cured finally may stick to the mold surface. That we do not want. Therefore, we supply or we apply the release gel before starting our process. Thin plastic sheets are used as mold surface, at mold surface, to get good surface finish. Another arrangement that is used to avoid the sticking of the product with the mold surface is the application or the use of the thin plastic sheets before the start of the process. A spray gun, as in our diagram we have used the term chopper gun, a spray gun is used to spray the pressurized resin, catalyst and the reinforcement in the form of chopped fibers. So the fibers that will be useful or that will be used in case of spray layer process will be short fibers only. A roller is rolled over the sprayed material. So once with the help of a spray gun we have sprayed the material on the mold surface, now we have to consolidate it with the help of a roller. So a roller is rolled over the sprayed material to remove the air trapped in the layups. Now, but as I have already told you, in the hand layer process also there is a tendency of the air bubbles or the voids being formed during the processing of the material. There is a tendency that we may get a poor quality product because of these air bubbles. Therefore, we need to remove this air entrapment or air bubble in order to get a good quality product, and in this the rollers come very handy. So roller is rolled over the sprayed material to remove air entrapped in the layups. Curing of the product is done either at room temperature or it can be done at a higher temperature also. So that depends on the product cycle, the processing cycle that we have developed or that we have designed for that product. If we want to make the product early, we want to have a high productivity, we may go for a autoclave curing also sometimes, and in normal circumstances if the time is not a constraint, we can go for room temperature curing process also. After curing, the mold is opened and the developed composite part is taken out and further processed. Now, some of you may be wondering that mold is opened is not clear to us, because in the diagram it was shown that we are only applying the material in the inside the mold and there is no secondary or the second half of the mold. There the mold is only in one half. So in order to get a good surface finish on both the surfaces, now you can see that in case of the mold that we have taken, the surface, the bucket surface will give good surface finish, but the inner surface may not be that good. So sometimes what is done, that another part of the duplicate part of the mold is placed inside, placed on top of the laid up portion, so that the other surface also gets good quality. So during the opening process, we lift this second half of the mold and then we take out the product. But still it remains an open mold process only, because the laminate is open to the environment, it is not closed. So sometimes, in order to get a good surface finish on both the surfaces, we may go for maybe a two part mold, as we have taken in the case of a hand layup process. If you remember the hand layup process, the diagram that we have seen there, there are two metallic plates and in between we are doing the layup. So here also, if you see that we can put another half of the mold on top of this, and finally we can take it out and get good surface finish on both the sides of the final product. So therefore the term opening is coming into picture. Now let us try to see this manufacturing of a boat by spray layup. This has been taken from YouTube. All of you, as I have already told you, that there are number of very good videos available. We are only selecting a very few just to acquaint you with the process. So this video is also available. The source is also given here. You can watch this again and again and try to appreciate the process which has been used for making a boat by the spray layup process. And I would like you to be slightly attentive and see that how a big structure has been made. This is the boat. You can see the size of the boat. And now the process is going to start. So first of all, we require a mold. So the mold will be prepared. In this case, it can be a wooden mold. The machining is being done in order to develop the mold. So this is, you can see a CAD drawing of the mold on the screen of a computer. So once you have this mold ready, see the mold, this is the, you can gauge the size of the boat by seeing the people who are working to finalize this mold. So the wooden mold is being created. And you can see in the last class I told you, finishing of the mold is very, very important, because whatever we do in order to improve the finishing of the mold, that is helpful to us in getting a good quality product. So this is, you can see, spray or release agent is being sprayed so that our composite that is developed or formed do not stick to the mold. So first of all we spray, and this is the spray gun which is depositing. See the fiber coming, glass fiber roving. This is the glass fiber roving that is coming. It is entering into the spray gun, the chopper gun. It is being chopped and the material is being deposited on the mold. And this is, you can see, small glass fibers, and with the help of roller, the consolidation process is being done. This is the roller or rolling arrangement, and this is the consolidation being done with the help of roller. So you can see the size of the boat. And finally, sometimes we can do curing also, and this is maybe a glass fiber tape after the rolling process. Again, consolidation. This is a glass fiber tape at some specific sections in the boat to further consolidate. Now after curing, this is ready, so it has to be removed from the mold, and this is being lifted. The red portion is the mold which was fabricated from wood, and this is the boat that is ready. So this is the primary forming, in which the shape of the boat has been made ready. Now we will cut certain section. See, we have cut a different section, another section has been cut. All this will fall under the secondary manufacturing. So this is the basic structure of the boat that is ready. the basic structure made up of glass fiber and polymer, and then the other additional fittings, electrical fittings and electronic fittings, all those can be done and the boat can be made ready for operation. You can see the quality of the manufacturing process. So similar videos are available on YouTube where spray layer process has been used, and this is the heat. You can see the final heating. Being carried out. Final finishing. So that's all related to the manufacturing of a fiber reinforced plastic boat. And spray layup is one of the process which has been used for manufacturing of the boat. So you can see the size does not matter when you are using a hand layup or a spray layup process. So very big size, large size products can be made using these processes. So these processes are widely used for manufacturing of different types of fiber reinforced plastic parts. So source, I would again tell, like to highlight, kindly note the source, and you can again go to this source and try to look similar type of video, the same video again and again, and try to appreciate the process, that how the process can be used. Maybe I may not have been able to explain all the details related to the process, but looking at the video you can further get certain insights into the importance of this process. Now again coming to the theoretical aspect of spray layer process, you can see the type of raw materials that can be used. So epoxy, polyester, polyvinyl ester, similar types of raw materials that we used for hand layer process. So majorly thermosetting type of polymers are used for spray layer process. The reinforcement can be glass fiber, as the case we have seen in the video. Carbon fiber, Kevlar fiber and aramid, Kevlar aramid are the same fibers. Natural fibers can also be used for spray layer process, like sisal, banana, nettle, hemp, flax, coir, cotton, jute. So there are number of natural fibers which can also be employed for making the product using the spray layer process. So all these fibers in the form of chopped short fibers, flakes or particle fillers, etc. can be used. If you remember, in the hand layer process we have seen that these fibers have to be continuous fibers in both the directions in the woven mat form. But in case of spray layup, the fibers have to be chopped into short fibers so that we are able to spray them onto the mold or the surface of the mold. What can be the advantages of this process? Now I think all of the learners may have been able to differentiate between a hand layer process and a spray layer process. The major difference is that in case of hand layer process we use continuous fibers or the mat fibrous reinforcement in the mat form, whereas in case of spray layer process we use in the chopped form. The other difference can be based on the application of the two, or bringing together of the two constituents, that is how we are combining the fiber and the polymer. In case of hand layer process, we are stacking up, laying up the reinforcement layer by layer and then applying the matrix in between in the form of polymer, whereas in case of spray layup we are inputting our reinforcement into the spray gun, we are putting our polymer into the spray gun, we are putting our catalyst into the spray gun, and in within the spray gun all the three constituents are getting mixed and the mixture is being sprayed onto the mold surface. So the method of joining the reinforcement and the matrix is different in case of hand layup as well as the spray layup process. So the major advantages are it provides high volume fraction of reinforcement in the composite. So volume fraction is a new term. I think I have explained it in when we were discussing the basic concept of composite materials. So the volume fraction is the amount of by volume of the fiber present in the composite. So volume fraction can be of matrix also, it can be of reinforcement also. The example I have taken is of the reinforcement. So volume fraction can be 60% by volume of fibers, it can be 55% by volume of fibers. Similarly, the rest will become the matrix. So in case of spray layer process, we can get very high fiber volume fraction, which is good for us. If you remember in the last class, I have told you why do we roll the polymer out of the laminate, the excess polymer, sorry, why do we roll out the excess polymer from the laminate? In order to ensure that we have high fiber volume fraction, because fibers are the main load bearing members of the composite. So we do not want excess resin inside the composite. So here also automatically we get good fiber volume fraction because of the nature of the process. The processing is fast in this case, as we have seen, it can be automated. Tooling cost is low because we have to make a mold, as in our video we have formulated a wooden mold. So the mold cost or the tooling cost is not that high. It achieves better wetting of the fibers with fewer voids than with hand layup process. So that is another, we can say, advantage of the spray layup, that the void content or the air bubbles or air entrapment is minimum in case of spray layup process as compared to the hand layup process. So virtually there is no part size limitation in this technique. So you can have, we have seen the size of the boat, so there is no part size limitation. We can make very large products with the spray layer process. What are the limitations? Let us quickly go through the limitations. Poor rollout can induce structural weakness by leaving air bubbles, dislocations of fibers, and poor wet out. Yes, if we are not able to control our parameters properly, we may lead to a poor quality product in the form of dislocations of fibers, or the fibers getting not wet by the adequate supply of the polymer, or there can be air entrapment. But if we are able to control our process properly, if we are able to optimally and judiciously select the operating variables, we can very easily get a very good quality product, as we have seen in our video also. It is not suitable for parts having high structural requirement. So since the fiber is short fiber, so we are not expecting very high strength from parts which are being made by the spray layer process. Fiber volume fraction is difficult to control as we are spraying, and there is, as you have seen, that once we are consolidating, the fibers are also getting displaced. So there is tendency that the non-uniform distribution of fibers in the product may lead to maybe different properties at different position. So fiber volume fraction at different sections may vary, whereas in case of hand layer process, that problem will never occur because we have continuous fiber reinforcement in the form of cloth or a form of a mat, and then we are applying the resin on top of it. So the fiber volume fraction at any given section of a hand layer process will more or less be same. So the variation will be less, whereas that variation is more in case of a spray layer process. The process is highly dependent on the operator's skill also, because he has to spray and see that how he has to move, at what skill, at what speed he has to move, or he or she has to move, so that we are able to deposit the right amount of thickness at the right place at the mold surface. Finally, coming on to the applications, spray layup method is used for manufacturing lower load carrying parts like small boats. As I have already told you, for high end structural applications, hand layup process will be more suitable as compared to a spray layup process. But for low load carrying parts like small boats, bathtubs, fairing of trucks, duct and air handling components, sometimes storage tanks can also be made, furniture components can also be made using the spray layer process. So if you see the videos available on YouTube, if you go to other internet content that is available on spray layer process, you can yourself see the application spectrum of spray layer process. So with this, we come to an end of our section on spray layup. In our next session, we will discuss a different process for processing of polymer based composites. Thank you.